Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how you can build a wearable arc reactor. The project is very simple and it requires basic electronics and coding skills. At the heart of the project we have an 80Tiny85 connected to 6 LEDs through the two PWM outputs of the microcontroller. In order to complete the project we're going to need an 80Tiny85, we're going to need 6 LEDs, 2 75 ohm resistor, 1 100 ohm resistor, a USB lead and a USB power bank. On the screen you have the circuit diagram of the project. It uses the 80Tiny85 and its two PWM outputs. That's pin 5 and pin 6. They connect to a 75 ohm resistor and then to two sets of three parallel blue LEDs. Since the power bank I'm using was cutting off at around 15 seconds, I added another 100 ohm resistor between VCC and ground, so it draw more current and that made the power bank stay on. If you're running from a power bank that does not have that issue, then you can freely omit this resistor. For the project enclosure, I used a baby chrome lid to which I attached a wireframe printout of the arc reactor. I traced the lines that I wanted to keep with a marker and then I used an X-Acto knife to remove the white parts. After I finished, I spray painted the lid in black and that made it look really professional. Since I confirmed that the electronics work, I transferred the circuit from the breadboard to the lid. I used a hot glue gun to put the LEDs in place and used some thin wires to connect them using the same schematic. Here is the end result and you can see that I route all the wires to the outside of the lid in order to prevent any wire shadows later on. I used an 8-pin socket to connect the microcontroller and I soldered it in place as if it was the microcontroller. This way the microcontroller will be removable from the device if you ever want to replace or update its software. At the end I've added some more hot glue to the entire arc reactor so all of the connections are more sturdy and durable. At this point I've tried it under the shirt to see how it will look, but I found out that the light output is not even and it looked kind of broken. To fix it, I've cut two paper circles, one bigger and one smaller. I've glued the smaller one on the inside just before the exterior of the cut pattern and the other one to the back to prevent any light leaks. The change made a huge difference on the whole thing and it looked a lot nicer now. I've programmed the 80Tiny85 with using the Arduino IDE. And I'm gonna walk you now through the code that I used. At the beginning I'm setting the output pins into a variable that I'm gonna then reference. The LED pin 1 is the PWM 0, pin 0 on the 80Tiny85, and then the second one is pin 1. I have these two variables for setting up the limits on the minimum and maximum brightness of the LEDs. I have a variable that I'm gonna keep the last ping. We're gonna see what ping is and then the current time. In the setup function, I'm specifying both of the pins as outputs as I'm gonna running the LEDs directly from them. And I'm executing the boot sequence and then I'm recording what's the current value of the millis function so I can track time execution. If we go down to the boot sequence, what's happening inside is that I'm just ramping up the LEDs from zero brightness being full off to maximum brightness through steps of 10 with a delay of 50 milliseconds in each step, and this kind of creates the effect of gradual ramp up until the main loop function kicks in. And in the main loop we have setting a random value between the minimum and the maximum brightness set in the top section of the code, and then a random delay of up to 100 milliseconds. After that delay, I'm checking if the code has been executing for at least 3 seconds, and if it is executing for at least 3 seconds, then I'm just writing full brightness to the LEDs for 200 milliseconds, and this creates kind of randomness and like if something is happening within the arc reactor, and then the whole thing just loops every time. At the end, I'm really happy on how the project turned to be. I used the arc reactor on a custom party and it was a real head turner. If you liked the project, then give it a thumbs up or a down if you didn't. Please subscribe to the channel and let me know down in the comments if you have any questions or suggestions. Cheers!